Tonight on NewsWatch, a deadly day in Ukraine. More violent clashes between Ukrainian forces and pro-Russian protesters. Will that fighting ultimately lead to civil war?
Plus, the cost of climate change. Why some are fighting back against a new global warming report from the White House.
And how putting Americans behind bars has become big business for private prisons. All this and more tonight on NewsWatch. Good evening. I'm Mark Martin.
And I'm Wendy Griffith. Ukraine is losing its grip on several major cities along the Russian border.
Fighting between government troops and pro-Russian protesters is increasing, and with it, the number of casualties.
Caitlin Burke has tonight's top story.
The crisis in Ukraine grows more unstable by the day. Around 30 pro-Russian insurgents and four government soldiers were killed during clashes on Monday. Those deaths come as the Ukrainian government is using more military action to clamp down on insurgents in the east.
In recent days, the anti-terrorist operation has aimed to destroy heavily armed militants. Around 30 militants were killed. Also, their group around Slovyansk were eliminated. We tried to avoid having armed forces enter those cities where many peaceful citizens live.
Ukrainian troops are tightening security around some major eastern cities, but pro-Russian militias are advancing in other areas. This afternoon, surrounding a major interior ministry base.
We got information that this base was going to be attacked and the weapons taken. We do not want those weapons to be used against us.
Dozens of government buildings and police stations have been seized by insurgents over the past several weeks. Ukrainian authorities in the West blame Moscow for the continued unrest, saying it's an attempt to derail Ukraine's May 25th presidential election.
The Russians, Vladimir Putin, today would like this election not to take place in order to continue to exert pressure. It is up to us to convince him.
But Russia questions the timing of the elections.
Scheduling elections in times when the army is used against parts of the population is not conventional. This is not Afghanistan.
Russia says Ukraine should push elections back and first publish a new constitution. Caitlin Burke, CBN News.
For more on the situation in Ukraine, we turn now to Daniel Kochis of the Heritage Foundation. Daniel, do you think a civil war is imminent?
I don't think that a civil war is necessarily imminent, but I think that Russia's continued intervention, paying these local thugs, continuing to send in Russian special forces, it increases the likelihood of it. Unfortunately, the U.S. and the European allies are going to need to really show a lot of resolve in order to keep that country together.
In just a few weeks, Ukraine is supposed to hold a presidential election. With everything happening, do you think that's going to take place?
I think the election will take place, but the question here is, will there be violence around it in the eastern regions? How legitimate will the results be? The Russians are going to do whatever they can in order to destabilize the country. I think that the elections will go off, but what the results will be and whether or not those will be safe elections, that's another question, I think.
Do you think the U.S. and other Western countries should be doing more to help Ukraine?
The U.S. Certainly and our Western allies can be doing a lot more to help Ukraine. Unfortunately, the U.S. response has been rather tepid. In addition, the EU's response, the sanctions, they're basically just a slap on the wrist to a handful of Russians. And so this sort of weak-kneed response is why the Russians are continuing to press on the Eastern Front and to continue to try to control territory through this sort of asymmetrical means.
Why are we seeing such a weak-kneed response?
Well, I think it's just sort of, at least from the U.S. perspective, more of the overall Obama administration's policies towards Eastern Europe. And so, you know, you had the U.S. author of the Russian Reset, Michael McFaul, a couple weeks ago in a Russia radio interview, say that the policy has failed. And so this idea that Europe was calm, safe, U.S. can withdraw troops, withdraw support, that's clearly been shown in the Crimea region and in Ukraine not to be the case. And so I think that is sort of why the U.S. has had such a weak response. And for Europe, it's mostly a business decision. Many countries in Europe have very strong ties to Russian businesses, and they don't want to lose the profits that are there with putting in place stronger sanctions.
And quickly, do you see the situation in Ukraine being resolved anytime soon?
I don't think so. I think, you know, unfortunately, the U.S. response is going to continue to sort of remain tepid. We have seen some positive signs, the placement of 150 troops in the Baltic states and also in Poland, but these are temporary troops. The U.S. is kind of dragging its feet on, putting in place stronger sanctions.
Okay. Daniel Kochis of the Heritage Foundation, thanks for your insight, sir.
Thank you very much.
The U.S. is gearing up to help Nigeria search for the 267 girls still missing after being kidnapped from their school 3 weeks ago. The White House says teams of military and law enforcement personnel will head to the country as soon as possible. Meanwhile, worldwide rallies are taking place, bringing more awareness to the situation. The movement is called Bring Back Our Girls. One of those rallies took place today at the Nigerian Embassy in Washington, D.C. Many Nigerians are critical of their government, saying the president has not done enough to free the abducted girls.
Why it seems that we are angry at the president is because we want him to do more. Like, no one could come into the president's house, kidnap his children for over 2 weeks, and nothing is done about it.
Good point. Islamic extremists from Boko Haram are behind the abductions. The group is known for its violent stance against women and education.
The leader of South Sudan's rebel forces has agreed to attend peace talks. United Nations Secretary General Ban Ki-moon is in the African nation urging both sides to put an end to the violence that has left thousands dead. The UN head says South Sudan's president and the rebel leader are set to meet in Ethiopia later this week. The face-to-face talks will be the country's most significant political progress since fighting began in December. More than 1 million people have fled their homes, and aid workers fear a famine could break out if the fighting doesn't stop.
The Obama administration is more certain than ever that global warming is changing the daily lives of Americans, and it's going to get worse. That's the conclusion from a massive government report out today. The White House will likely use the report as a basis to try to reduce the emissions of fossil fuels like coal, gas, and oil. But Republicans and some Democrats have opposed many of those moves in the past, saying they cost jobs and hurt business. But President Obama will use executive orders to accomplish his goals.
We've heard that before. In other news, today marks the 66th anniversary of Israel's founding. Now a unique project is underway to preserve the history of the nation's early years by recording the memories of those who lived through them. Our Middle East Bureau Chief Chris Mitchell brings us this look at the Israel Chronicles.
The project is called Toldot Israel, which means the Chronicles of Israel, which is a project which is dedicated to recording the firsthand stories of people who were either involved in Israel's War of Independence or the pre-state era, or simply witnesses to different aspects of the founding of the state.
Executive Director Aryeh Halivni says many interview subjects don't understand that their story is special.
They don't see themselves as heroes. They said, look, what was I supposed to do? This is just what we needed to do at the time.
Elad and Zimra Peled met in 1946 in the Palmach, the Jewish pre-state defense, and they married during the War of Independence.
Elad was 20 years old, and he commanded Sfat, which is a very complex community, and he did it successfully.
So far, the project has interviewed 700 people, logging 3,000 hours of interview time. They're hoping to get several hundred more interviews, but since that generation is aging, time is running out. Some of these personal stories have been turned into short documentaries, like this one about the historic UN vote that created the State of Israel.
You spoke to the Belgian, and you spoke to the Swede, and you spoke to the Brazilian, preaching, explaining why all the time.
There were a number of us working at the same time also on getting votes. We sent down to Haiti a Protestant minister by the name of Sheldon, who was also believed that the Jews should have a homeland.
The material will be housed at Israel's National Library, and people can also access it online. The Peleds hope the project will help teach the younger generations.
People don't know the history of this country.
Many days when we went to bed, we didn't know if we'll get up in the morning still alive. And if this whole so-called country will survive.
In our generation, we talked about we and not I. In this generation now, individualizing everything, they lose a lot.
When people try to complain, this is bad, that is bad, we had worse situations already, and we overcame it.
Chris Mitchell, CBN News, Jerusalem.
Thanks, Chris. Coming up, how a loving father and businessman ended up behind bars for a crime he was convicted of more than a decade ago.
Announcing an important breakthrough in healthcare that can benefit everyone. If you or anyone you love needs affordable health insurance, regardless of a pre-existing medical condition, call Quick Insurance 123 today and get the immediate relief you deserve. Quick Insurance 123 was created to provide affordable health insurance to all uninsured Americans, with or without pre-existing conditions. This is not a discount card. This is a real insurance program that lets you choose from many affordable health plans, with access to doctors, hospitals, emergency services, and more. So call the number on your screen now and get the health coverage you need just for calling. As a special bonus, we'll send you a free prescription savings card that could save you up to 85% on your prescriptions. That's right, you could save up to 85% on your prescriptions just for calling. Call Quick Insurance 123 to find out how you can get affordable health insurance and receive your free prescription savings card just for calling. Don't wait. Getting a free quote is as easy as 123. Call today.
This is a national healthcare alert from the Health Hotline. If you, a family member, or a loved one suffers from knee pain and have Medicare as your primary insurance, we've got great news. You could qualify for a pain-relieving knee brace at little or no cost to you. Get free delivery, and all the paperwork is handled by our accredited suppliers at no charge to you. If you are on Medicare and have knee pain, don't wait. You may qualify to immediately receive a pain-relieving brace at little or no cost. Friendly agents are standing by 24/7 to help you. Call the Health Hotline right now for details, toll-free. Our friendly representatives are standing by now to take your call. We also have other pain-relieving braces available for shoulder, ankle, and your back. You may be eligible to receive these items and more at little or no cost to you as well. Call right now for details, toll-free.
Operators are standing by. Call 855-740-8143. That's 855-740-8143. Again, 855-740-8143. That's 855-740-8143.
Welcome back. A Missouri man convicted for a robbery more than a decade ago never went to prison due to a clerical error. When the state caught the error 10 months ago, they tracked him down and arrested him, but now they're setting him free again. In 2002, Cornelius Mike Anderson was sentenced to 13 years for armed robbery, but the order for him to go to prison never came through. He asked his attorney what he should do, but the attorney said to just keep waiting. So while he waited, Anderson got his act together, starting a family and a business, coaching youth football, and volunteering at his church. When the state took him into custody last July, 35,000 people signed a petition calling for his release. It took a judge about 10 minutes to set him free.
Just so thankful. Thank God for everything. Thank the public. Say thank you and cut my hair. Get all this off my face.
I'm very, very, very happy. Very happy. And again, I thank everybody for all their support.
What a great story. The judge said Anderson's crime-free life as a husband, businessman, and volunteer shows he is a changed man. The victim of the armed robbery also supported his release.
All right. Well, Heather Rice-Minus is senior policy advisor for Justice Fellowship and joins us now from our Washington, D.C. bureau. Heather, this is obviously a unique case, but if Anderson had served his sentence, he'd basically be leaving prison with nothing. He wouldn't have had all the business and the coaching, and he might not even be rehabilitated. What does that say about our current system?
Well, I think this is just another example of how we so often default to thinking about incarceration as the only form of punishment. But in reality, it's not necessarily the most transformative or effective way to punish those who have committed crimes. And we think that at Justice Fellowship, we believe that victims and communities should be involved in thinking about alternatives to incarceration.
Are there better alternatives than prison when it comes to rehabilitating convicted offenders?
Absolutely. And we think one of the most important things about coming up with those alternatives is letting victims have a voice. Too often the government plays the role of the victim. And what we believe is most important for restoring both the community, the victim, and the offender is to let them have the voice. Let them be the ones who bestow mercy. They're the ones who have the opportunity to truly bestow mercy, not someone, not the bureaucracy. And in this case, I'm grateful to see that that's what happened. The victim stepped forward and actually advocated that he thought that Mr. Anderson should be freed, and the judge abided by those wishes.
Yeah, that's true. Now, you know, Anderson sort of rehabilitated himself. He decided, I want to be a better person. I'm going to go this direction. Now, not everybody who got a free pass, so to speak, would do that. So is this something that we can say, you know, everybody should do?
Everybody should get a pass?
Well, it's not something that every person that got a free pass would do and make good choices, which he did. So we have to sort of have a balance, don't we?
Absolutely. The justice system needs a balance. We need to make sure we have proportionate punishments, but we also need to make sure we're providing opportunities for people to be restored. And Mr. Anderson is truly exceptional. I mean, he took his second chance, if you will, and he ran with it. He not only was law-abiding, but he contributed to his community. He's obviously a devoted father and husband, a football coach, a taxpayer, a business owner. And so I think this is an example to us as Americans, that when we really truly can give people a second chance, and we should be part of making sure that people who return from prison or who are involved in crime have those opportunities and that victims are given a voice in the process.
It's a great story and a happy ending. Heather Reisminus, thanks so much for joining us.
Thanks, Wendy.
Up next, how prisons have become a place for big business to make lots of money.
Announcing an important breakthrough in healthcare that can benefit everyone. If you or anyone you love needs affordable health insurance, regardless of a pre-existing medical condition, call Quick Insurance 123 today and get the immediate relief you deserve. Quick Insurance 123 was created to provide affordable health insurance to all uninsured Americans, with or without pre-existing conditions. This is not a discount card. This is a real insurance program that lets you choose from many affordable health plans, with access to doctors, hospitals, emergency services, and more. So call the number on your screen now and get the health coverage you need just for calling. As a special bonus, we'll send you a free prescription savings card that could save you up to 85% on your prescriptions. That's right, you could save up to 85% on your prescriptions just for calling. Call Quick Insurance 123 to find out how you can get affordable health insurance and receive your free prescription savings card just for calling. Don't wait. Getting a free quote is as easy as 123. Call today.
Attention sleep apnea patients. Are you tired of the expense and hassle of getting your CPAP and BiPAP supplies? Are you fed up with dealing with ill-fitting, leaking, or worn-out masks and straps? Are you worried about the effects that unsanitary tubes, cushions, and filters have on your health? If you said yes to any of these questions, Allied Medical Supply Network has the solution to your problems. You could qualify to have your supplies regularly delivered right to your door at little or no cost to you. That's right, no more inconvenience, no worn out masks and straps, no more unsanitary equipment, just restful sleep. Call Allied Medical Supply Network today to determine if you may qualify to receive your fresh, brand name supplies at little or no cost. Don't delay. Call us now to see if you are eligible to save money on regular delivery of your CPAP and BiPAP supplies. Call 1-800-815-9947. That's 1-800-815-9947. Or go to CPAPSupplyHelpline.com.
More than 2 million Americans are in prison, and keeping them behind bars is a multi-billion dollar business.
That's why the private prison industry is looking to expand. Jennifer Wishon explains in tonight's Focus Report.
They're major players in corporate America, companies operating inside a $74 billion industry. What are they selling? Prison cells. They contract with dozens of states and the federal government to house inmates and illegal immigrants. The industry has been around for decades, but conditions are ripe for a major expansion.
As the states are increasingly being crunched for space, facing very strong or very large deficits, they need to find ways to reduce costs. And so this is one way that they can help solve budgetary problems.
Dr. Mulhausen says private prisons like this one in Washington, D.C. offer government savings of about 3% and reduce prison overcrowding. It's a savvy business model, but the contracting of the caging of humans to private companies operates under a cloud of controversy. Jesus Cardenas was locked up for check fraud. He served 9 months in a Texas-run prison, then transferred to a private facility run by Corrections Corporation of America, or CCA, for the rest of his sentence. He tells CBN News he immediately noticed a difference in the level of security.
They were just going through the motions. These officers that were there were just drawing a paycheck. When I say go through the motions, instead of going through my property to see if I had picked up any contraband or anything of that nature, they went ahead and used my property slip that I left the unit with.
Surveillance video of a 2010 brawl at this Idaho Correction Center run by CCA exposed problems some former inmates claim are common. Critics complain private prisons cut corners on salaries, guard training, inmate medical care, and facility maintenance to add to their bottom lines.
The model as a whole has not had a happy history.
Dr. Fran Buntman is a criminologist at George Washington University.
Is it a good idea for for-profit businesses to be in the business of locking up criminals?
My short answer is I don't think so.
She says there are lots of reasons why. The most basic can be traced to the foundations of America.
Ethically, we need to deal with the fact that when we have chosen to put people in prison and we've taken away their liberty rights to control their own lives, we as a society and the government as the institution looking after them actually have a responsibility to their welfare. We as a society cannot subcontract out that responsibility to a private agency.
What's more important, people or money?
John Whitehead, founder of the Rutherford Institute, compares private prisons to big box retail chains.
I'm not saying corporations are evil, but corporations exist for one thing, to make money, maximum profit. That's okay if you're making widgets or toothpaste, but when you're dealing with people and you're making money off a prison, you're starting to treat people like they're toothpaste.
But Mulhausen counters it's the criminal justice system, not the prison industry, that still determines who gets locked up and who doesn't.
You have to get arrested and prosecuted by the state before you're sent to a private prison. And then a judge has to release you, whether it's based on early release because of your behavior or because you served your full time. And so the private institutions don't set the intake or outtake of prisoners.
It's one reason investing in the jailing of people makes good financial sense: high recidivism. CCA cites studies that reveal high numbers of inmates return to prison again and again. Buntman says turning the imprisonment of people into profit leads to the over-criminalization of Americans and de-emphasizes rehabilitation.
By giving financial incentives to imprison people directly or indirectly, including through private prisons, what we're doing is we're finding a way to increase the incentives to put people in prison.
Despite the controversy, experts anticipate the private prison industry will continue growing. Whitehead says he expects the criminalization of America to grow with it, including the incarceration of more women and children.
I think America's lost its way. I think the way we view people, the old Judeo-Christian viewpoint that people were created in the image of God, they had great worth and dignity. We should care for them. We should try to get them on the right path. No, I think we look at people right now in a very suspicious way.
Jennifer Wishon, CBN News.
Up next, how the internet helped one woman get a new kidney.
thing on? Hey, kids, do you love games? And do you love discovering things? Yeah! Well, do ya? Yeah!
Then you're gonna love this. It's the new free Superbook Kids Bible app. You can play games, watch videos, find answers to your questions, and a whole lot more. The new Superbook Kids Bible app. Free downloads available on iTunes and Google Play now.
Announcing an important breakthrough in healthcare that can benefit everyone. If you or anyone you love needs affordable health insurance, regardless of a pre-existing medical condition, call Quick Insurance 123 today and get the immediate relief you deserve. Quick Insurance 123 was created to provide affordable health insurance to all uninsured Americans, with or without pre-existing conditions. This is not a discount card. This is a real insurance program that lets you choose from many affordable health plans, with access to doctors, hospitals, emergency services, and more. So call the number on your screen now and get the health coverage you need just for calling. As a special bonus, we'll send you a free prescription savings card that could save you up to 85% on your prescriptions. That's right, you could save up to 85% on your prescriptions just for calling. Call Quick Insurance 123 to find out how you can get affordable health insurance and receive your free prescription savings card just for calling. Don't wait. Getting a free quote is as easy as 123. Call today.
Attention sleep apnea patients. Are you tired of the expense and hassle of getting your CPAP and BiPAP supplies? Are you fed up with dealing with ill-fitting, leaking, or worn-out masks and straps? Are you worried about the effects that unsanitary tubes, cushions, and filters have on your health? If you said yes to any of these questions, Allied Medical Supply Network has the solution to your problems. You could qualify to have your supplies regularly delivered right to your door at little or no cost to you. That's right, no more inconvenience, no worn out masks and straps, no more unsanitary equipment, just restful sleep. Call Allied Medical Supply Network today to determine if you may qualify to receive your fresh, brand name supplies at little or no cost. Don't delay. Call us now to see if you are eligible to save money on regular delivery of your CPAP and BiPAP supplies. Call 1-800-815-9947. That's 1-800-815-9947. Or go to CPAPSupplyHelpline.com.
Well, finally, people turn to the internet for just about everything these days.
And that apparently includes kidney donors. Instead of dialysis, Cindy Prettyman decided she wanted a kidney transplant. But none of her family is a match, so her son turned to the website Craigslist for help. After posting a wanted ad on the site, a matching donor called him the next day.
They told me it could be 5 years, maybe even 10. Depends on my condition, my blood type, and all that. So my son didn't like that idea. So he said, he put an ad on Craigslist.
Do I know I'm going to be in pain? Of course. Of course. I'm going to be in pain, and she'll hear it. She will hear it. But you know what? 2 weeks to help her have a better life, I'm all for it.
Wow, what a servant's heart. A local church near the donor is helping raise money for medical bills. Another great story.
That lady was a total stranger?
I think so. Yeah. Found her on Craigslist.
I mean, I've heard of people buying furniture and clothing and stuff on Craigslist, but never a kidney.
I know. What do you know?
Praise the Lord.
A lesson to all of us.
That's all for this edition of NewsWatch.
Thanks for watching. Good night.